Lynette Madison here at NASA Johnson Space Center, and I'm at a wearable technology summit today, or a wearable technology symposium, where a group of University of Minnesota students are here talking to NASA engineers and explaining how wearable technology, or e-textiles, I think is what they've told me, can actually help NASA engineers create futuristic spacesuits. So with me today are Grace Lorig and Mai Yang, and also Jessica Loomis. So Grace, you're gonna be our spokesperson today. So tell me a little bit about what your project was this past semester?
Yeah, we've been working on it the entire semester. And our problem was to create a warning system for the astronauts to wear in the space station that set off an alarm in all different levels of emergencies with three different modalities. So we used visual, tactile, and audio alarm systems.
Okay, so this had to be something that they could be lightweight so they could fly it to the space station. It had to be wearable. Can you kind of tell me some of your challenges?
Well, a lot of the challenges came in using fabrics that they could move well in, but could also support the electronics system that's wired throughout it, and then also being able to channel it through. And you can see on here how where the lights are located and the speakers and the motors and how they have to go through the sleeves and all the way back down into the pack that we have built into the back, which is this.
So you're all fashion designers, or this class was an apparel design class from what I understand. Had you ever worked with electronics before?
Nope.
Was this a challenge for you?
Yes, but our professor is really good at working with all different kinds of e-textiles, so she helped us a lot.
Was this a fun class?
Yeah. The beginning of the class was a lot of learning about physics and human factors and stuff like that, so we had to integrate that into.
And so that was not something you'd ever studied before?
Nope.
So physics is new to you. So tell me a little bit about what you've created here. You've got a jacket.
Yes.
And what does it do?
Well, it has three different levels of warning, so kind of just to get someone's attention, and then a cautionary, and then a high level of emergency warning. And there's also one system built in where if we could only use two modalities, they would be used, and it's a tactile and a visual alert, because visual is the sense that we use the most to get our attention, and then tactile is more like close to the body, and you catch your attention maybe quicker than if there was outside sound. And then there's also a button where the user can alert other astronauts in the space station, so it has a light and a vibrating motor on the shoulder to tap them on the shoulder and get their attention. And then also this tab is an emergency, a high level warning emergency that they can set off themselves.
So let's see a demonstration.
Okay, this is the lowest level, and it's just a yellow light that's on. So yellow is the most visually stimulating color, so they can see it, but it also, we intuitively read it as a caution, so it's not as high level warning. And then the medium level, the lights start to blink, and there's also, at the same time, there would be a beeping, which is not going off right now, and there's motors vibrating on the back in the same kind of pattern with the lights. So the blinking moves it to a second level of warning, because it reestablishes the warning every time it goes off.
So they'll know that it's a more serious warning, because you're getting a sound, you're hearing a sound, you're feeling something in your back, and you're also seeing the light. So
yep.
What happens when you get the really serious warning?
And the highest warning, a red light comes on, the beep becomes more frequent, and so does the vibrating pattern on the back. And
is that annoying?
No. And also red is the color we read as a warning, so that's why we incorporated red into it. And then also, this is the high level warning of just the two modalities. You can't tell that the motors are going off, but they're going off with the lights. And then, that's the button that she can push to get the attention of the other astronauts in the space station. And then if she were to pull the tab, this is what happens.
Very good. So did you sew this yourselves? Did you all worked on this?
And
you
yep.
all, you cut, did you design the pattern? You cut it all out?
Mm-hmm.
How did you decide that? And how did you put all of these electronics into this very nice little jacket?
It was kind of a learn as we went kind of a thing. We at first we had to plan out kind of the wiring system, so initially we did testing to figure out the placement of things and where they were best, where they best caught the attention of the user. And then we patterned out wiring, so this is its own channel through the arm to let the wiring go through. This yoke right here has wiring that comes back through here, and then the back on both sides, this channel leads down into the pack in the back. So that was something we patterned right away. And then the gray fabric is stretch fabric, since this had to be woven so it couldn't stretch. We wanted the user to be able to move around a lot because that's how they get around the space station, is with their arms. So that's why we incorporated stretch fabric into there. And then also where the woven fabric is, we put a lining inside, and it also supports the wires that go through the garment.
So you learned a lot about electricity and a lot about making fashion.
Yes, yeah, and of course also along with that, we wanted it to be aesthetically pleasing. So it kind of ended up being cool looking at the same time.
I think it is very cool looking. Well, that sort of leads me to your consumer product, because you had to do something for NASA in your class, but you also had to make a consumer product.
Mm-hmm.
So this is very nice looking, and what is it?
This is a biking jacket, and we tried to figure out some activity that someone would be doing where they would want all three modalities, or where they would be useful. And the first thing that came to my mind was biking, because I feel like there's a lot of miscommunication in bikers and people on the road. So we put the lights in. This is on the right arm, so it would be a constant yellow light that would be on, so that people in cars and other bikers could see their arm when it was raised, signaling right or left. And then on the back, this would be a constant red light, so kind of like the light that they put on their bikes, but it's also on the garment. And then a right and left shoulder light, so that they could push. There's a button on the left arm that they can use to signal whether they're going right or left, so it would flash. And then there's also a motor built on each shoulder, so that they can either, if they're biking with someone, whether they're in front or behind them, they can get their attention by just tapping one and tapping their shoulder, or one or the other, to tell them if they're turning right or left. And there's also a speaker built in, and the idea behind that would be like when you're backing up your car and it beeps when you're getting close to something behind you. So the hopes would be that the speaker would be turned on when there was a car approaching or something close behind you, and it would alert you.
So this is your consumer product. What is your next step?
Well, from here, we can take some classes, other classes offered by the U. Our professor also offers a human factors course, so we could learn more of those things to incorporate into garments. And I also think there's a technical design class she's teaching. And we're working on our senior line next year for our final project, and some students might incorporate some of the things we learned here into that, like other active wear, other functional designs, stuff like that.
How many students are in your class?
There's 16, I think.
Have you always worked on NASA projects, or have you done other things?
This is the first year we've worked with NASA, but previously they worked with companies like Nike and 3M.
So when you work with companies like 3M and Nike, do you take those products onto their company? Will this possibly be a NASA space suit item, or NASA something that we use on the International Space Station?
Well, they're prototypes for them to work from. I don't know if they'll use the exact thing, but I know that there are certain things that maybe the placement or some of the intuitive things that we built into it that they might add into things that they're already working on.
Is it exciting to do something like this, to work on an actual project?
Yes, yeah. It was scary at first, but
but you managed, because you had never done electrical design and all of that. Well, that's wonderful.